All right, now that we got the front view started, we're just gonna work on projecting down that chimney. So again, we're gonna come over here to our construction layer. If it's too confusing, really, we just need those construction lines temporarily. So you can delete out those so that we can kind of start from scratch here. Set that construction layer current, and let's draw a V for vertical. And we just need that line right there. Just lets us know how far out that chimney goes. We're gonna do more construction lines, H for horizontal, and we're gonna project over these construction lines. So we need from here to here. We need that flashing. We're actually gonna see that flashing from the front. So from here to here. And then obviously just down to the floor level, we can draw that there. So this is, where we're gonna start drawing, go back to our elevations layer. We should probably go ahead and project. Not that, well, we could just copy. We're gonna go to the elevations layer, we're gonna copy. This, I should have projected one more, just where it actually hits the wall. There we go. That I should have just brought, that's the size of the chimney, right? So from the outer part to the part where it hits the wall, just so we can see how wide it is here. So we've got this chimney, we're on the elevations layer. Again, you can just trace over this, you can draw a rectangle, however it is that you see it, it's gonna end up being a rectangle. And then let's just draw a line. So we've got a line from here all the way down to here. Really, you're just gonna see a rectangle. I'm gonna draw a line from here down and over. And then this was the flashing. Remember, these two lines right here were the flashing. So I'm gonna go ahead and draw a little rectangle from here to here. And let's turn off that layer so we can see what we got behind the scenes here. So that's the flashing that we see that was projected over here. So these two points right here are the flashing. I'm gonna go ahead and trim out the middle line. Looking good. I'm gonna trim out this because the roof kind of goes around the fireplace here. Now remember, we have that trim on the sides of it. And so let's see, we did that trim, I believe at 3.5 inches. Yeah, you could do a 4-inch trim just to make it easier on yourself. So we could offset, I'm just gonna go with 3.5 since that's what we were using already. 3.5, 3.5, almost done here. We need, remember this thing was offset just a little bit by 1 inch, just for that 1-inch overhang. I'm gonna go ahead and explode this. And then I'm gonna do my offset. One on either side. Get rid of this line. And you know what I'm about to do, don't you? Yeah, you do. Fillet, radius of 0, M for multiple, oops. Fillet, radius of 0, M for multiple. Click here, click there, click here, click there. You know, I just love this. Just brings it to a perfect corner. I don't have, ooh, not that one. I don't have to worry about it. Looking good. All we really need now is this little chimney cap. You can reinsert that block, or you could just copy the one that you have already. Just make sure when you copy it, you're picking it up from the midpoint so that you can put it at the midpoint over here. And look at that. We have a nice looking fireplace right there. Yep, that's it. Okay, next up, we're gonna be doing the little side water closet. Actually, before we do that, let's go, it's kind of annoying me that we have not yet done that foundation here. So let's just go ahead and do the offset. Offset, what do we make it? 18 inches. Let me explode these. And then we can do offset 18 here to here. Let's go ahead and fill it Why wouldn't we fill it? That is such a grand deal. There we go. So there is the foundation of our house. If we look back over here, this is what we're talking about. I just did that foundation of the house. Yeah. All right. So next step is, well, let's hop back over here. Next step, we're going to do this little water heater closet so we can see it the side in the side over here. Once we draw it there, then we can come over here to the side view and draw it in that view as well. So let's go ahead and do that.